AI can analyze and generate insights at incredible speeds. But does that come at the cost of your data security? Today we are exploring how Microsoft Copilot, combined with Purview's sensitivity labels, keeps sensitive information secure, even in complex workflows. Hello world and welcome to a new Azure vlog. In today's video, I'll discuss how sensitivity labels secure data handled by Microsoft Copilot. If your team uses Copilot to automate data insights, sensitivity labels ensure every interaction respects data confidentiality. I'll cover real-world examples, demos, and the best practices to show how this combination of tools helps safeguard your organization's information. Let's jump in. So imagine you're an HR manager creating a confidential report on your company salaries, or an executive summarizing sensitive legal documents for the board. With sensitivity labels, you can classify these documents as confidential or highly confidential, restricting access based on user's permission. When Copilot interacts with these documents, it respects these labels, preventing it from sharing sensitive content with unauthorized team members. Now let's jump into how you can set up sensitivity labels for Copilot. I will go quickly through this process as I already have a whole video dedicated to sensitivity labels. In this video, we'll focus on the copy and extract permissions, which play a vital role. These permissions define whether sensitive content can be copied, printed, or extracted by other users or apps, including Copilot. So let's dive into Purview. So welcome to the Purview portal. I am in the information protection solution. And if we look in the menu, we have the option sensitivity labels over here. If I click on that, you can see all the labels that are deployed in my tenant. I have a public label, which is public information and can be shared externally. I have an internal label, which can be applied on data that should never leave the organization. And I have a classified label, which only specified people have access to. So if I first click on classified, let's wait for it to load and go to the edit page. If we click on next over here, this label is applied on files, emails, and meetings, just as the other labels. I will use this one for controlling access. And here it gets interesting because here I can control who has access and with what permissions. So as you see over here, currently only I have access to files that have this label applied. If I click on edit over here and click choose permissions, you can see the exact permissions that are applied to this file. I can view the rights, I can edit the content, I can save the file, I can edit the rights, but I don't have the copy and extract content permission. And this is the permission that Copilot uses for extracting information and copy it in, let's say, a new document. So as soon as a document has this label assigned, the label confidential, we are not able to use this with Copilot. If I click cancel over here, and we now go to our internal label. I can also go to the edit page over here. Let's quickly go to the page where I can view the current permission set over there. It's also used for controlling access. And here you can see that the whole tenant, this is the tenant name, has co-author permissions. If I click on choose permissions right now, we can see that the copy and extract permission is assigned. So this is interesting because in a few minutes I will show you what the end user experience will be like. And you can see that we can get content out of this document. So let's now focus on what our end user is experiencing. But first, let's grab a very good cup of coffee. A nice cup of coffee. Now let's see how this works for our end user. Imagine that a team member is working with sensitive project files labeled as confidential and asks Copilot to summarize key points. Let's switch over to my desktop. Okay, so welcome at my testing workstation. I'm logged in as a user right now and we have a document available called intellectualproperty.docx. And it's classified. So Copilot should not be able to do something with it. If I ask Copilot to summarize this file, please summarize. If I go to files over here, I have my intellectual property. If I hit go, it's now trying to read the file. What you see over here is that Copilot is responding that it's not able to summarize the document as the content is protected. So Copilot is not able to do something with a file that is being protected. If I now go back to Word, I change the classification of this document to, let's say, public. I set the previous label no longer applies, I click on change. Of course, I save my document. Let's now try and ask Copilot again. Please summarize my intellectual property document. Hit enter. And as you can see, it's now able of giving me information that was in my my document, which I think is really, really nice. This is a way on how we can protect our documents quite easy. That worked well, but what happens when new data is created based on existing sensitive files? For instance, if a team member generates a summary that pulls insights from internal files, Copilot applies the same sensitivity label to the newly created content. This is also called inheritance. In fact, let me show you how it works. So I'm here in Word. I've opened a new Word document. It's currently classified as public. So let's ask Copilot to add the content of another file into this this file. I will use my internal document for this, which is classified as internal. We are already seeing here that this one is auto-classified. If I now click generate, it's creating a draft. It's working on it. As you can see over here, my classification of the document has changed. This looks good. I will keep it. So this is a way on how Microsoft Copilot protects the integrity of our files. As this content is internal, it will automatically classify my new file as internal as well. Amazing, right? Microsoft Purview and Copilot provide a dynamic, intelligent way to keep data secure. With sensitivity labels, you can rest assured that every Copilot interaction respects your data security policies. In this video, you saw how you can create sensitivity labels in Microsoft Purview. When a user has the copy and extract permission on the label, Copilot is able to use that document in its responses. We also had a look at what the user experiences when he or she is using Copilot with a sensitive labeled data. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button. Also, subscribe to this channel. And of course, I hope to see you in one of my new videos. Bye!